he told Dean Towns, why don't you see if old Roy can find some of the old blues singers I used to see at the Newport Folk Festival back in the 60s and the Philadelphia Folk Festival. And so B said to me, Doc wants you to do this. You want to do it? I said, yeah, I'll do it. And they said, you'll be my advisor. I don't want to know anything about this blues thing. I'm busy with the bluegrass thing. I don't know much about that now. They call me an expert. I said, okay. So I did it for 2 years. And then he said, here's your budget. He said, just hire whoever you want and tell them to call the office and tell them to send a contract. I said, yes, sir, Mr. B. Downs. So I've been doing this for 29, 30 years, I think. Over the years, we had a lot of people. Doc saw at the Newport Folk Festival or the Philly Folk Festival. And all the old black gentlemen that made records in the 20s and 30s are gone now. And where are the old guys? The thing about the old country blues is so unique. So many different styles and regions. The Carolinas, of course. The most famous guy in North Carolina was Bonneville Fuller. Himself to death many years and decades ago. Mississippi had played different in Atlanta, they played the Big 12 strings. I'm going to tell Lead Belly. We got Todd Albright here playing the old Atlanta sound. We got one of his big guitars like Lead Belly had. You got a big guitar, you tune it really low. This is between here and here, so you put on real heavy strings, you tune it way down low, and they rumble like the heavens. Look at your watch, you got a date or something? I'm gonna get started here in a minute.
Sweet. If I want to be back one more, you know the chief will make you believe.
was a little